Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm just talking about organizing TV shows and even a few like transformation style movies to like help you get in the mood to clean and organize. So the first one is called The Minimalist Lifestyle, and this one might actually end up being a little bit controversial. You think it's gonna be like a TV show or a movie, and it ends up being almost like an audiobook that they put to a PowerPoint presentation. And I did notice on the reviews that not everyone was into it, and I totally understand, but I watched the entire thing all the way through, and I thought that the information that they had in there, the process that they go through, was very different from what I have seen from other minimalists. They had tips like how to automate your life and creating a space that's just for you. And then they also talk about the benefits of having a minimalist lifestyle, specifically decision fatigue. And I thought that that was like sort of a really interesting approach. The next one that I wanted to talk about is also on Amazon Prime. It's called Bea Organized. It's 10, you know, teeny tiny episodes, kind of like a YouTube style almost, but sort of combined with like an HGTV style video. And it's a woman named Beatrice, and she kind of goes into people's homes and she takes, you know, little projects that they have, like their bathroom, for example. She has a small budget, and then she sort of does like DIY fixes, things that you can usually find at like Target or the Dollar Tree. And then she also has sort of little one-off project episodes, Hoarders on Amazon Prime. Now this one is my personal favorite, probably because they're just very satisfying. So essentially it has like a professional organizer with a cleaning service, sometimes even a hazmat team, and a psychologist. And they sort of like go into a person that has like a hoarding disorder and help them get everything back to zero. And they clean out the entire house. They do work on maybe the factors that sort of led to the hoarding. And you can tell that they are genuinely trying to help people. That one is one that just really has always motivated me to get cleaning. And so that's one. If you check out anything, go ahead and check that one out. This next one I have heard about but not seen. And it's called Clean House, and it's on Hulu. And I need to sign up for Hulu. I might be the only person left that doesn't have a subscription. But from what I understand, it was on the Style Network, and there's a woman, and she goes into homes and she basically helps them declutter and organize. That sounds right up my alley. If you've seen it and you want to like leave a comment, let me know if it's any good, go ahead and do it. I'll probably end up binge watching it tonight anyway, because that's kind of the mood I'm feeling. But I thought that one sounded good. So as far as like Netflix is concerned, they have two really great shows and one movie. And the first one is Tidying Up with Marie Kondo. Now she's the author. I'm sure you've heard of the book by now, but it's The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up. I have the book, I read it. Now she has a very specific process that she goes through to declutter. It's something that she started years and years and years ago. And I have done a little research on her in the past, but she was always very organized even as a child. So this is a process that she developed, you know, over the course of several years. Anyway, here's the book, but she definitely believes in sort of a tidying all at once. I want to say she starts with books, or maybe it's clothing, and she basically takes people through her entire process start to finish. But more importantly, she teaches them and then she makes them do it themselves. And my favorite episode is probably the first one, because it's a family with, you know, two children. I think it might actually be called like Tidying with Toddlers. I just felt like every episode is relatable to someone on some, you know, way. So I think I sold you on it. Did I sell you on it? Okay. The Queer Eye series, they have a few different series. I like The Queer Eye more than A Makeover. So it's basically, it's a group of gentlemen and they each have like different strengths. So one is a hairstylist, one is an interior designer, one is like a clothing stylist. And they take someone who is sort of like down on their luck, or maybe they had a big change in their life, like a divorce, or they moved, and they kind of like help do sort of like a whole life. I think that's a good way to say it. Just like a whole life approach to getting them, you know, cleaned up and organized and feeling good about themselves. And I think it's a good show to watch if you're interested in kind of like leveling up your home or just leveling up in general. I particularly like that they take like nutrition and dietetics. And they take that approach to sort of help feed people from, you know, starting on sort of like the inside and then working their way out. And they definitely sort of like help people talk through their problems, and they do it in a very gentle way. I wanted to talk about it's called The True Cost, and it was a documentary that I probably watched a year ago. And it talks basically about fast fashion and how sometimes the clothing buying processes of developed nations ends up sort of like coming at a cost to less developed nations, and how the textile industry in, you know, places like India is, you know, dangerous, and they have really poor working conditions, and they're, you know, not paid a living wage, and how all of this sort of like feeds into this industry. And after I watched it, that was when I sort of had that watershed moment of, man, I'm doing a little, my piece in this, you know, giant pie is negative, and I need to really start like thinking about how I view clothing and purchasing. And by this, I just mean buying less, for sure, buying secondhand first, focusing on quality, and then like looking into the manufacturing processes of the brands that I do buy. I did want to go through and just list some of my favorite, I mean, I'm going to call them like transformation movies, but basically movies where, you know, the protagonist sort of like goes through a process, usually set off by a negative event, and then sort of like comes into their own or reaches a goal or just sort of like realizes maybe something about life that they didn't necessarily realize before. I'm just gonna list my favorites, and then I'll list if I can find it someplace, you know, free or not free, I guess. So the first one is on Amazon Prime. I know this for sure. It's called Brittany Runs a Marathon, and it did not get as much traction as I thought it would. It's about a woman named Brittany, and she decides to lose weight, and the way that she decides to do this is to start running, training for a marathon. She wants to start running, and it's such a subtle movie. It's such a subtle film and the approach that it takes, and it just pulled at my heartstrings, and the character is incredibly relatable. The acting is smart. The directing is smart. It's not lazy in any stretch of the imagination. So I thought that was like, that's a good film to start if you're looking for something new. The rest of these I think are like oldies but goodies. Legally Blonde, Under the Tuscan Sun, which always makes me want to cook. Clueless, Sabrina. The Devil Wears Prada, which always makes me want to dress better. Teen Witch, which this one I must have been in middle school and it came out. It's actually about a girl who finds out she's a witch, and she uses her powers to sort of like upgrade her life, and then at the end she ends up finding out like who her true friends are and what's really important. So that one's a cute one if you can, you know, dig through the archives on that one. Pretty in Pink, The Holiday, has Cameron Diaz and Kate Winslet. Kate Winslet is sort of in an unrequited love situation, and she ends up coming to America and sort of like rediscovering herself. And the writing's, you know, the writing's really good. The acting's really good. Jude Law is in it, which does not hurt. The other one I have, which is Bridget Jones' Diary, which I just rewatched. And it's just so, those movies are just so funny, and I just enjoy them. So I just wanted to give you a list of things to watch if you, you know, have come upon some time where you're doing a little bit more TV watching. And I'm filming this April 11th, so all the information I'm giving about where these shows are and if they're available or not is, you know, as good of today, April 11th, 2020. So that is it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this, please get, you know, subscribe, come around. I do lots of organizing videos. If you don't like it, you can thumbs it down too. I need to know that. There's no ego here. Thank you so much for watching.